Rumor has it again that there's another Margrave coming. We'll see if that's happening or not. And if it is, it's been 3 years since Aces. Camelot does not take that long to develop games. Sorry. And even then, Camelot started the next project long before Aces' release. So we'll see what happens. There's a rumored list of titles for this direct. I don't know if I believe it because it also includes Legend of Mana. I don't think we're gonna get Legend of Mana remake, but we'll see. One problem that people might have is they might think this direct is 50 minutes long. It's gonna be better than what average direct, but I mean, it has potential. They got one, so you'd think it would be, but they might be overhyping it to the point where they think there's gonna get a lot more than we actually are. I think it's be good no matter what, though, because we finally get a nice announced lineup for 2021. Even the Smash characters that's what I care about, the games are what I'm interested in. I don't think they'll start in Smash. I think it'll be right in the middle, but we'll see. Maybe they will. Here we go. What are they starting with? I'm a little nervous, but even though I shouldn't be because I don't care that much about Smash character. It's loud. Too quiet? Oh, okay, there we go. They could start a Smash though. This might be Smash. This looks like Smash. It's Rex and Pyra. It's Rex and Pyra. Okay. Interesting. I was expecting them to come in.
One day, Pyra just disappeared.
Unless this is. No, maybe this is actually Xenoblade Chronicles 2-2. Pyra's in Smash! It's Pyra, not Rex! Oh, it's Pyra!
It was as if she vanished off
She's in as Pyra! Oh, man. It's freaking Pyra and Smash.
Whatever it takes. This is where you were.
It's Smash.
Sorry, Rex. I couldn't tell you.
What?
I got an invitation to join Smash.
Wow! It's just Pyra! Okay, interesting. Well, there we go, another first party character. Okay. Mithra? Mithra, yep. So it's Pyra and Mithra. I was wondering how they'd handle them, but I guess it's just Pyra and Mithra. I'm surprised they started Smash. Kind of. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be getting at least the final character is at least gonna be another first party, so we're looking at maybe one more third party at most. It was probably Lloyd, I think. Interesting, okay. But, see, Xenoblade is also kind of a little bit lacking in music, too. Poor Rex. Oh man.
Quite the spectacle.
Yep.
There.
Yep.
Wait,
Gramps.
Oh, I've missed this, buddy. Mind if I watch a while?
The Rex costume. Oh boy. So Rex joins in for the final smash. Alright.
Shulk?
I never expected to see you two again. Well, now that you're in Smash, I won't go easy on you!
Ooh, fighting words. You forget. We're fighters too!
Okay. So now we're gonna be getting, the Monster Hunter costumes with Pyra and Mithra.
Nathan.
Hello, everyone. It's been a while. I'm Shinya Takahashi from Nintendo. Last year, we delivered some news through a series of Nintendo Direct mini presentations. However, we haven't been able to present a Nintendo Direct in this style for some time. I'm happy to share this Nintendo Direct with you all today. We appreciate your continued support. Okay, what you just saw was the reveal trailer for the newest fighter in the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game, Pyra and Mithra. They originally appeared in the Xenoblade Chronicles series as Rex's 2-in-1 ally. Please look forward to seeing their moveset in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
So March?
This fighter releases in March,
yep.
So we hope you'll stay tuned just a bit longer.
Okay.
All right, let's continue with our first
battle. So we got our first party character.
Switch headlines.
Oh, Fall Guys. Is this coming to Switch? This is one of the things that was on that leaked list. But people have been expecting Fall Guys for a long time, so it doesn't necessarily mean anything, but we'll see.
Toward greatness when Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout comes to the Nintendo Switch system summer 2021. You have 22 minutes before the solar system is destroyed.
Our wilds
to the vast reaches of space to uncover the secrets left behind by an ancient civilization. You have 22 minutes. After that, the sun will explode, and the solar system will be annihilated.
I don't think they'll do another Smash Fair, but maybe they will. I don't know. I don't think... I'm still thinking no, but maybe they will. Who knows?
By repeating these cycles, you'll gradually unravel the mysteries hidden in the universe. What messages will you discover? How can you prevent the sun from exploding? Why is the solar system trapped in an endless time loop? Find out when the critically acclaimed Outer Wilds
okay.
launches on Nintendo Switch summer 2021. Put your sleuthing skills to the test in two classic...
Wait a minute, isn't this...
Famicom Detective Club.
It is!
And Famicom
They're localizing
Club,
it!
...stands behind. Two deep cuts from Nintendo.
Oh, that's cool!
Coming to North America for the first time.
We know they're being we know about the remakes, but this has never been confirmed for the outside Japan until now.
Drama and twists and turns.
That's cool.
Every corner. You'll be on the edge of your seat as you dive into these deep narratives set in Japan. In one game, you'll solve a complex murder case surrounding a wealthy family in a haunted village while dealing with amnesia. But that's not the only case to crack. In the other game, you'll investigate a supernatural rumor after a mysterious death to free students from a sinister nightmare. interrogate suspects, and hunt for clues to piece together these chilling conundrums. Can you figure out who the culprit is before it's too late? Uncover the deadly truth in Famicom Detective Club The Missing Heir and Famicom Detective Club The Girl Who Stands Behind, coming to Nintendo Switch May 14th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. A new age of battles begins.
Is this Samurai Warriors 5? Because that was one of the things that on that list. Yep.
The latest entry in the Samurai Warriors franchise is coming to Nintendo Switch. Dive into the history of the Sengoku period as the series now shines the spotlight on Nobunaga Oda and Mitsuhide Akechi. Character designs and visuals have been revamped for this installment. Unleash high-octane moves in electrifying 1 versus 1,000 battles. In Samurai Warriors 5, slashing its way onto Nintendo Switch, summer 2021. The vast world of Fadiel beckons. After 20 long years, Legend of Mana, featuring remastered HD graphics, is coming to Nintendo Switch. You'll set off on a journey to find the mystical mana tree seen in a dream. Before discovering the world map is empty. During your travels, you'll acquire special items called artifacts.
Place them. This isn't as upgraded as the other games, though. Like, the other full remakes, this is just kind of like a remaster.
It's up to you on when and where to place artifacts, as well as how to advance the story. Join forces with characters.
Because I guess you can expect Mario Golf then.
Square off against fearsome monsters. Or take a break from adventure and rest up at home. The music has been rearranged for this enhanced version, and you can alternate between the new arrangement and the original soundtrack. Other features have been added, including the ability to turn off enemy encounters, as well as the new minigame, Ring Ring Land. Legend of Mana will launch on Nintendo Switch June 24th.
I have important news.
That's this rise, okay.
Go assemble the villagers. 50 years ago, Kimura Village was attacked by the Rampage and Magnum Malo. And we suffered some devastating casualties.
How can we fight against that?
Our hunter's about to face the biggest challenge yet! No! We can't lose this gate! Pull yourselves together!
You're not getting in!
Let's go, everyone!
Go rampage somewhere else!
You listen to me now!
Watch out for the apex! Do not let it pass!
The rampage. How long do you think it's going to last? Inoue, we should start preparations right away.
We're here to offer assistance! We must stop the calamity!
Mars finds it. Yep, okay. So we can see Mario golf, huh?
That was the latest trailer for Monster Hunter Rise from Capcom. How will our heroes fare against these ferocious monsters? Stay tuned for the latest installment in the Monster Hunter series, launching March 26th. Next, please take a look at this.
Mario Golf.
The fairway is open once again.
All right.
Tee off in the latest installment of the Mario Golf series, coming to Nintendo Switch.
Serious, okay.
Study the wind and terrain. Take your time to think things through. Then swing. Enjoy golfing with familiar Mushroom Kingdom characters on courses filled with lush, natural scenery. Use features on the greens, like a shot gauge, to see how your shot will curve due to slopes, and a scan that lets you examine a course's terrain. These features can help you ace your shots. In addition to button controls, you can also use motion controls by holding a Joy-Con controller like a golf club. Gently swing the controller to have your character swing in the game, letting you easily enjoy the sensation of golfing. On top
They're
of all
running?
That, there are several modes with new elements that truly bring the heat to Mario Golf, including this one, Speed Golf. Here, it's always your turn. Everyone tees off at the same time, then you'll race through the course to reach your ball. Give it another whack to get it closer to the hole, then keep going. Outpace your opponents to come out on top. Your golfing skills aren't the only things at play. Make use of dashes and special shots to beat the competition. Oh, did we mention story mode? As a Mii character, you'll start out as a rookie and develop your golfing skills while interacting with various Mushroom Kingdom characters. Level up with experience points earned during matches. Then, allocate points to different stats, allowing you to develop your character however you'd like. You can also use your Mii in versus play. Put your golfing skills to the test.
Yeah, June 25th. That was actually just leaked. Vergemen said June 25th was this one's coming out.
Begin on Nintendo eShop after this presentation.
The latest game in the Mario Golf series adds new gameplay for multiplayer modes, as well as the familiar golf gameplay with easy-to-learn controls. Please look forward to this game on Nintendo Switch. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Wait, the trailer come up.
Check out these games coming to Nintendo Switch. Return to the unforgiving world of Pandora in Tales from the Borderlands. Play as the Hyperion lackey, Rhys, and the quick-witted con artist, Fiona, as you set out to recover a mountain of cash. Set between Borderlands 2 and 3, this game includes all 5 episodes, filled with classic Borderlands humor. Gangsters, bandit lords, and vault hunters are just a handful of the obstacles you'll encounter in this choice-driven narrative adventure. Embark on a wild ride when Tales from the Borderlands launches on Nintendo Switch March 24th. 32 of Capcom's most beloved arcade classics are coming to Nintendo Switch. Rewind gameplay, adjust game speed or difficulty, and select from a variety of display options to relive that sweet arcade goodness. Get 1943 The Battle of Midway for free, then purchase game packs or the standalone Ghosts and Goblins add-on to build your collection. Local co-op play is also available. Scratch that nostalgic itch when Capcom Arcade Stadium launches later today. Brains! As a zombie, you just can't get enough of them. In this action game from Aspyr, you'll build your zombie horde and take revenge on the city by turning humans into your undead allies. Replenish your bodily arsenal of sputum head, gut grenades, and more during your grisly mission. This city ain't no match for a dead man. Stubbs the Zombie in Rebel Without a Pulse eats its way onto Nintendo Switch March 16th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. It's Travis Touchdown versus Assassins. Wait, aliens?
Nowhere Heroes 3.
Aliens have invaded Earth. Hold up, is this even the right game? Anyway, after annihilating an entire city, the aliens have taken over and now host an intergalactic superhero ranking tournament to decide Earth's fate.
Here we go.
As the crass, beam katana-wielding assassin Travis Touchdown, you'll need to fight your way to the top to save the world.
What's wrong?
Hey, not so fast. To enter each boss fight, you'll have to do some odd jobs around town and earn enough to pay off the entry fee. You'll then face off against a slew of unusual opponents.
What?
Most of them aliens with some crazy tricks up their sleeves. Study their tactics to change up and
combat. Oh man, classic RPGs. Like Final Fantasy.
You'll have access to a variety of deadly skills that can be customized and upgraded before each match. The fate of the world is at stake. So get ready to kick some, aliens have.
Release date.
Kick. Anyway, it'll all make sense when No More Heroes 3 lands on Earth.
August 27th, okay.
Nintendo Switch, August
27th. Nice, alright.
Exterminate demons in heaven.
As above, so below. Why do they need assassins in heaven? To do someone's dirty work. It's kill or be killed. You won't last long if you can't rely on yourself. God's judgment has nothing to do with it.
Uncover heaven's mysteries in neon white, coming to Nintendo Switch, winter 2021. The DC superhero girls are here to save the day.
Hi, everyone. My name's Barbara Gordon, a.k.a. Batgirl. I'm always inventing new gadgets to fight crime, like my batarangs and backhook. This is Supergirl. She's super strong and has heat vision, plus super breath. And let's not forget Wonder Woman, an Amazonian warrior who wields the lasso of truth. Along with our friends Green Lantern, Bumblebee, and Zatanna, we fight evil supervillains to keep our city safe. But we're not just about the super life. We also have our school lives, and trust me, there's never a dull moment at Metropolis High School. Sometimes it'd be nice to get out of class and do some shopping downtown with my besties. Ooh, and maybe take some photos to share on Superstar Post while we're at it. Hey, I got a comment already! Nice! Ooh, and I definitely want to hit up Sweet Justice later. Uh-oh, something really bad is threatening the city. No one could have seen it coming, but when justice calls, you can count on us to answer no matter what. We've just got to make sure no one figures out our secret identities.
DC Superhero Girls Teen Power heroically soars onto Nintendo Switch June 4th. Ready the juice cannons and prepare for battle.
Juice cannons? Oh, Plants vs. Zombies, okay. So, the Mario Golf trailer did not show Camelot in it. It only showed Nintendo. Whereas the Mario Tennis Aces trailer did show Camelot. Doesn't mean anything necessarily, but just interesting thing to note. The thing that people miss is the fact that, Aces, Camelot moved on from Aces before it completed Plain Gold. They moved on before, never mind. We'll keep an eye out. We'll keep an eye out, okay.
Who will join you in your adventure?
Oh, here's Miitopia. Yeah, this is on League 2, a new Miitopia game.
On a quest to face evil and save faces. Miitopia is coming to Nintendo Switch. Cast Mii characters in various roles across the kingdom. Turn your favorite people into your allies, or even make someone the nefarious Dark Lord.
Oh, man.
Makeup has been added as a new feature in this game. Glam up your Miis and get them ready for adventure. There's also a new wig feature, letting you go wild with your Mii creations and make them even more fabulous. In the world of Miitopia, relationships are key. So consider spending some quality time with allies to strengthen bonds. This can give you an advantage during battle. If your relationship's sour, though, things might take a turn for the worse. Whoa! You can have a horse as an ally? That sounds pretty darn good! Care for it, and it'll lend a hand, or poof, in battle. Venture with friends and familiar faces in the lighthearted romp Miitopia, coming to Nintendo Switch May 21st.
May 21st, okay.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. Super Mario themed
coming
to your island.
For the anniversary? We haven't seen Zelda stuff yet. We'll get Ninja Clan DLC.
Items are coming to the Animal Crossing New Horizons game.
Well, in any case, this covers a second, available game. So it could be that this is it. This is all we're getting for available games. But I'm still hopeful that we might see Age of Climbing DLC.
You can also place two warp pipes.
That's actually a cool mechanic.
Then use them to travel between locations on your island. Hey, why not try recreating the Mushroom Kingdom?
That's actually a really cool mechanic.
A free update for the game launches February 25th.
Okay.
After
downloading, that's next week.
Super Mario Bros. Items will be available via Nook Shopping starting March 1st. Keep an eye on the official Animal Crossing Twitter account for the latest information. We hope you continue enjoying life on your island.
Alright.
How was that? These collaboration items will be released.
We've got about,
as part of the Super Mario.
Oh, we still got over 20 minutes left.
Anniversary events. Please wait a bit longer.
Anniversary events. I'm about to lead to other anniversary events.
Speaking of which.
Yep.
Last week, we had the global launch for the Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's.
Maybe they'll announce DLC for it.
We hope you enjoyed that Mario adventure as well. Next, we have another game to show you.
Okay. This looks like Octopath! Oh, it is!
He leaves us no recourse! Swords! Never!
The latest in the HD2D series, this is the a new,
Are these the wages of loyalty? Raised earth and burnt corpses.
There we go, this is cool.
And no other must decide how we proceed.
But this looks like it's more of a,
And must be the beacon others look to when the night is darkest.
Is this based on Final Fantasy Tactics?
Today you burn!
I promise to do all in
this is based on Final Fantasy Tactics. Oh! Cool. Triangle Strategy? Another project game. Okay.
Far away
lies the continent of Norzilia, comprised of three nations and limited deposits of salt and iron. The constant feuds among the nations over these precious resources eventually ignited into a
great conflict
known as the Salt Iron War. Though the hostilities ceased with an uneasy truce,
okay,
decades later, the flames of war threatened to engulf the realm once again.
You are all that remains.
Caught in a tangled, fiery web of plots and conspiracies, a brave group from Glenbrook fights to save their kingdom from the powers that would orchestrate their downfall.
Our benefit, you say?
They're actually focusing a lot on this one. We're probably going to see a new Fire Emblem game, too.
A character's attack range is determined by their location and their equipped weapon.
Yeah, that's just like Final Fantasy Tactics.
By attacking from higher ground with long-range weapons, such as bows and arrows, thus your forces can use the terrain and other elements to gain the upper hand. An enemy outflanked is susceptible not only to your initial attack, but also a powerful blow from the ally positioned behind the enemy.
What have we here?
Charge into an enemy to send them flying into position for a follow-up attack.
We win.
Link attacks together by first casting ice magic on the flames to create water terrain. Then electrify the area with lightning.
Oh, this is so cool.
It is of the utmost importance.
Chocobos? No, they're birds. It makes sense because this isn't actually Final Fantasy. It's just kind of inspired by Final Fantasy.
Throughout the story,
they're heavily focused on it, so this is gonna be like 5 minutes on its own.
In a variety of situations. Utility, morality, liberty. Collectively, your decisions will establish your conviction, affecting how the story unfolds and who will join your cause.
Okay.
Once more, I would ask you plainly, do we or don't we relinquish Prince Roland to Estrost?
Critical decisions that may determine the fates of nations are settled by vote on the scales of conviction. Use information you've gathered to sway allies toward your favored cause. The story will significantly change based on how the votes are cast.
So they refuse to relinquish him to us.
Lies! His hand was forced!
As more and more critical decisions are made, your journey may take you down paths divergent from those of other players.
You will see what true might is.
Project Triangle Strategy, a brand new tactical RPG from Square Enix, will launch in 2022. Please be on the lookout for more information.
This is a new one. This is coming next year.
After this presentation,
makes sense because it's kind of soon for it. But
download on Nintendo.
Because Brave Default 2 was supposed to last year, so this is coming next year.
Player feedback. We look forward to hearing your responses on the demo.
Please look forward to future updates on this brand new tactical RPG from Square Enix. Okay, let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Headlines, yep.
Calling all hunters. Do you have what it takes?
Yeah, this is a Star Wars thing. This is heavily, rumored elite or whatever, I'm not sure, but it's some sort of remaster or something? Or is it a new game? Maybe this is a new game.
Star Wars Hunters is a competitive, free-to-play online game set between episodes 6 and 7. Clash in this third-person shooter coming to Nintendo Switch in 2021.
Oh, I think this is new.
Alright, let's do this.
Alright, Sal.
Warcraft?
Do I look at you or the camera?
No. This...
Knockout City interviews, take one.
What?
We all play for different reasons.
Gorgon loved battle. Gorgon used many weapons. Triple-bladed war axe, spear
what
of
the
misery,
heck is this?
Hades soul-devouring crossbow.
A princess is supposed to lead her people, not be stuck up in some tower waiting for a hero.
In my line of work, bullets
what
are
the heck is this?
Flaming longsword, blade of doom.
This looks like an advertisement.
Just
once I'd like to catch one.
And granted, the direct basically isn't advertising, but...
With this crown, I'm gonna lead my team to victory and kick some serious ass!
Look, it's simple.
Gorgon want new weapon!
In Knockout City, I'm like a kung fu master. I can catch bullets!
What the heck is this? So it's some sort of attack, ball attack type game, multiplayer game.
Lost it! Can't believe we're losing to a bunch of dairy farmers! Okay, team, they may have won the battle, but not the war.
Hey, can we redesign our characters?
You're not a team if you're not wearing a uniform.
Max, this is a war zone, not a bloody fashion show!
Pass to me!
I mean, a war...
What? Interview's over? Come on, man! One more game!
So it's called Knockout City, okay. May 21st.
The fight for survival starts now.
Hang on tight, because you're all going to play a little game of fate for me!
Wait, is
From
this...
the creators of the Danganronpa and Zero Escape series comes
okay.
a fight for your life.
I was saying, this looks like Danganronpa.
It's oriented and trapped in an underwater theme park. The 12 of you, known as the Go-Getters Club, must now survive this game of fate at all costs.
I don't want to die yet! Sorry to scare you all, but... the game is cancelled!
The game is suddenly called off. You escape the theme park and get a glimpse of Japan, but everyone's vanished. Set off on a captivating journey across the country that blends side-scrolling action with suspenseful narrative.
Be the one behind the whole game of fate!
As you make your way back home to Tokyo, you'll alternate between working solo and teaming up with the group to overcome challenges and monsters that stand in your way.
Okay.
What awaits you all at the end of your journey? The battle for survival begins in World's End Club, venturing onto Nintendo Switch,
okay.
May 28th.
So only one game is coming not in...
Wield the powers of Olympus.
Only one game here isn't coming by August so far.
Dungeon crawler and recipient of multiple Game of the Year awards is getting a physical release on Nintendo Switch. This version comes with a couple of extras to assist you on your journey out of the underworld. The first is a PC download code for the Hades original soundtrack. It's packed with 2.5 hours of blood-pumping music composed by Darren Korb, known for his work on previous Supergiant titles like Transistor and Bastion. The second is a 32-page full-color character compendium featuring portraits of the game's vibrant cast of gods, ghosts, and monsters, all by Supergiant's art director, Gen Z. And let's not forget the game itself, offering dozens of hours of exhilarating action paired with a compelling story. Escape the underworld again, or for the first time, with the physical version of Hades on March 19th. Three deadly action games, one masterful collection. Ninja Gaiden Sigma. Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2.
Yeah, so these are finally coming now, too.
And Ninja Gaiden.
He's been rumored for a long time, so it's not too shocking if I see him, but
as
yeah.
The action-packed Ninja Gaiden Master Collection. You are the legendary ninja Ryu Hayabusa, fighting against a great evil with battle skills that are second to none. Wield an arsenal of killer weapons, each offering a playstyle with different set of lethal skills, along with ruthless ninjutsu to swiftly take down enemies. Quickly gauge your opponent's movements while unleashing fast and frenzied combos, and team up with other super ninjas in your quest to fulfill your destiny. All previous downloadable content, including costumes and game modes, are included. Revel in the intensity of Ninja Gaiden in one dynamic collection. Ninja Gaiden Master Collection slices its way onto Nintendo Switch, summer 2021.
Oh, here we go, guys! Yes!
More battles
yes!
Coming to Hyrule.
This is what I wanted! So what are we getting here for DLC? Oh, yeah, there you go. Robbie and Pure are coming. Expansion pass. Oh. It's only two packs. Huh.
There's even more coming to Nintendo Switch.
Bravely Default 2
is almost here. Four heroes of light will soon embark on a journey to restore the crystals. Use the job system to develop your characters and master the Brave and Default commands to emerge victorious in turn-based battles.
I live to fight.
Veterans and newcomers to the series can enjoy this brand new story on February 26th. A new trailer for Bravely Default 2 will be revealed following this presentation.
Following it?
The game can be pre-ordered on Nintendo eShop. Weird. An updated demo is also available. The latest installment in the legendary Ghosts and Goblins series comes to life. As the Brave Knight,
there's about 10 minutes left. Maybe they'll end it on one long preview.
Challenging stages within the Demon Realm. Local co-op play is also available for the
They haven't shown anything Zelda yet. Except for Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity DLC.
Carry for transportation or Archie for
bridge. And it looks like Age of Calamity's DLC is a little more limited, so it makes sense. They are going to just focus on Breath of the Wild stuff. Kind of sucks, but oh well. I was hoping to get more than that.
Eight protagonists.
But we're definitely getting the all the characters are in the base game, and maybe a few more from Breath of the Wild, and maybe from Breath of the Wild 2.
Travel through a stunning sci-fi world with any of the protagonists, each with their own stories. With the addition of the playable protagonist Fuse, new gameplay features, exhilarating battles, and a new scenario for the protagonist Acelus, Saga Frontier Remastered.
Oh, it's a Saga game! Okay.
The game launches April 15th. Apex Legends is storming onto the Nintendo
Switch. Yeah, this has been rumored for a long time, too.
This free-to-play Battle Royale features a growing roster of powerful contenders named Legends, strategic combat, cross-platform play, and more. All players on Nintendo Switch can get an all-new Legendary Pathfinder skin and 30 free levels for the Season 8 Mayhem Battle Pass. Plus, for the first 2 weeks after launch, earn double XP when you play on Nintendo Switch. Fight for fortune, fame, and glory when Apex Legends enters the fray March 9th.
How's it going so far? There's still a little bit more to show you in today's Nintendo Direct, so we hope you'll stick with us. Next, please take a look at this.
Hello there. I'm Eiji Aonuma, producer of the Legend of Zelda series.
Okay.
I'm sure a lot of you saw me and thought there might be news about the sequel.
Yeah, they're not going to show it.
Breath of the Wild game. Unfortunately, we don't have anything to share right now. We apologize. Development is proceeding smoothly, and we should be able to bring you some new information this year. For now, we'll have to ask you to wait just...
So they're going to talk about the anniversary, show off maybe a collection or something.
While you're all waiting, however, this Legend of Zelda game will be coming to
Skyward Sword.
Switch. Please take
Skyward Sword. Or it could be a new 2D Zelda game by Grezzo. Skyward Sword. Okay, here we go. Skyward Sword HD. All right. Okay, that's cool. How's it gonna work, gameplay-wise? So I think that's all we're gonna get for Zelda in this presentation. So what did they get ended on? Donkey Kong? Okay, Skyward Sword HD. About 5 minutes left.
What you've just seen is The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD. This game originally released in 2011 on the Wii console, and now it's coming to Nintendo Switch.
Yep.
The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword featured a control scheme in which players would use the Wii Remote Plus controller as a sword and the Nunchuk controller as a shield. With the increased processing power of the Nintendo Switch system, the controls here are smoother and even more intuitive. And we've recreated the controls for the sword and the shield here by having the player hold two Joy-Con controllers. The Joy-Con controller in your right hand.
So they're gonna spend a lot of time on this.
Swing it to have Link swing his sword in the game.
I'm guessing they're gonna end it on a quick preview of Donkey Kong.
The controller in your left hand is the shield. By lifting the controller, you can raise the shield to block enemy attacks. You can perform other actions like using.
There's one other option I can think of, but I'm just like, I don't want to spec on that right now.
Add a sense of urgency and tension to combat. But we've also made it possible to play the game with button controls.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Button controls.
Handheld mode or on the Nintendo Switch Lite system.
About 5 minutes left.
Over how to assign
this is a really good direct, though, either way. Any kind of DLC is what I really want most. Skyward Sword HD is great, too.
Tilt the stick down when you want to swing the sword downward. Swing to the right, to the left, or diagonally. Just tilt the stick in the respective direction.
Is this just gonna be how they end it?
Here's something else we've been working on. Specially designed.
Okay. That's cool.
The right Joy-Con controller is themed after the Master Sword, while the left features a Hylian shield motif. The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, as the game depicting the earliest story in the Legend of Zelda timeline, details the events around the creation of the Master Sword itself. We hope that people who played the original game on Wii and those
so there's time for one more thing left.
Enjoy discovering the origins of the Legend of Zelda.
July 16th.
Legend of Zelda Skyward okay. Sword HD.
That's a pretty good time frame. We got a lot of good stuff coming up through August
following
now.
This Nintendo Direct, you'll be able to pre-order the game on Nintendo eShop. And the specially designed Joy-Con controllers will launch on the game's release date at your local retailers. Many of you may already know this, but The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword was the last original console game prior to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild game, and it was still following the established conventions of The Legend of Zelda. However, it gave a glimpse into many features and innovations that would eventually be adopted in The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, using the sailcloth to descend in midair, a stamina gauge that depleted as you scaled walls with vines or ran.
They're still talking about the Skyward Sword.
I hope those of you who've played The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild will give this game a try as well.
Okay. I'll probably pick it up.
Please look forward to The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD.
Okay.
Well, what did you think? The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword has been optimized for Nintendo Switch. It includes intuitive motion controls and button controls by tilting the right control stick. Okay, the next game will be our last announcement for today. Please take a look at this.
Donkey Kong. That's not Donkey Kong. It's Splatoon! Huh. So it's a Splatoon spin-off. Alright. What the heck is this like a, I wonder if what they're doing is they're exploring the ruins of the old world. Cause their cities aren't built there. Yeah, that train is still running. Yeah, okay, looks like they're, what they're doing is they're exploring the ruins of the old world. It is boring. I want to see something. Please let me see Splatoon 3. It's Splatoon 3. So it's sort of being a Splatoon spin-off. No Mario Kart either. When's it releasing? Okay, makes sense. I didn't think it'd be this year. So, we're definitely getting, in Age of Clan, we're definitely getting, Pyra and Robbie. But what does the past look like? It's like, okay, here we go. Purchase bonus available May 28th. Wave 1 available oh, wow! Wait, what? They're adding costumes until last wave. They're adding characters to the last wave. That kind of sucks, actually. I don't like this lineup. So, purchase bonus. Available May 28th. Newly added weapon for Link. Newly added costume for Link. And what the weapon could be. I'm assuming it means weapon type. No! No, wave 1 says weapon types. So it's just a standard weapon. I guess it makes sense, though, because you don't want to add a weapon type as a purchase bonus. So wave 1 is newly added weapon type, so it's probably... I wonder if that would be... Sorry, I misread that. It does say expand roster right at the top. Expand roster. So I'm guessing wave 1 is going to at least include Pyra and Robbie. I'm hoping each one has 4 characters. Newly added challenging enemies. Okay, cool. I like the challenging enemies. New challenges in the Royal Ancient Lab. Newly added weapon types. Okay, this doesn't have stages. Character vignettes. So in other words, the first expanded roster is only characters who are already in the base game. That's why this has new character vignettes, because there's going to be new characters added too. Assuming based on this live, it sounds like it's probably gonna be like, Wave 2. I guess it will be based on Breath of the Wild 2, because it's coming in November. I'm guessing it'll be based on Breath of the Wild 2. New character vignettes, add stages. So the add stages are probably gonna be like, it's probably gonna be a new storyline with a few new stages, and these stages are gonna, expand the existing story. So we'll have a few new stages to play through, new roster. If this is based on, like, the future timeline, maybe that could be, you include Cass, and you throw in, like, say, Ganondorf, new battle, I don't know what battle skills means. What does battle skills mean? Okay. So, new weapon types, could be, like, Link getting a new weapon, Zelda getting a new weapon, Impa getting a new weapon. If they do this, like, focus on this, they could potentially add in, like, weapons based on... I can see that happening. I can see them add weapons for the champions based on the other characters from the original Hyrule Warriors. That would be a really easy way to do it. Link could get a weapon based on that too. Zelda could get like a rapier or something. Impa could get one of Impa's previous weapons. And we're definitely getting Pyra and Robbie. Hard to say if we'll also get Soga and Aster. I kind of hope they do, but they might wait for them until the Wave 2 where they can add a new storyline. They don't tell you how much is there, though, so that kind of sucks. In any case, this is available May 28th, so that's nice. We're getting it soon.